good morning, good afternoon, and good night. Smart Fox Jr. This is Become the Podcast. How do you become anything you dream, you declare, you commit? And success is your next breath. We are listening to the sounds of D'Angelo, one of my favorite artists. I've been fortunate enough to see Prince when he came to Detroit. Prince was so live, I never even found my seats. We ended up on some sort of landing, and we stayed there, and we danced the whole night away to every Prince song. And then my mother-in-law, Shelly Tursky, and Jim Tursky, they gave me, Sarah and I, an opportunity to go see Stevie Wonder. And so that was incredible. And I've been fortunate enough to see some other people, but Stevie Wonder and Prince are the ultimate. And so the person I want to see the most is D'Angelo. So with that being said, that's who we're listening to today. So it's been a long day. Finally got a chance to get out the house and do some actual work. And because I was kind of ripping and running and going for meetings and doing a bunch of stuff outside of the crib, I didn't get a chance to record. So I'm doing it late. It's 9:25 p.m. The Rockets and the Warriors are playing, and I'm doing this during halftime so I can get back to the action. So what I want to talk to you today about is the A game. And the A game is a way in which you can acknowledge the situation that you're going through, make sense of it, and then accelerate with what you need, leaving back or leaving behind the stuff that you don't. So the A game consists of you acknowledging your situation, accepting your situation temporarily so you can appreciate it, and then you can accelerate with what you need and leave behind the crap. So you see, there's four A words: acknowledgement, acceptance, appreciation, and acceleration. And so here's the analogy that I'll give you. Throughout life, we're going to decline, right? Physically, we're going to decline. But throughout life, let me start over. Throughout life, we are walking with this wagon or this barrel behind us, right? And with each step we put in there, in that wagon, a memory. Oftentimes, that memory is a gem covered in junk, right? So it doesn't even look like a gem. It looks like just a clunk of dirt and rock and rubble and whatnot. But inside that, there is a gem. So now, as we get older, we decline. And our health and our strength takes a downturn, right? We may not get sickly, but we're definitely not as strong at 76 as we are at 36, as we are at 26, right? As we get older, we continue to pull this wagon, and we accumulate experiences. That wagon becomes very, very heavy over the course of time with those big chunks of stuff. So it's up to us to take every opportunity or every experience, get rid of the junk, and so we can find a gem. Because at the end of the day, we want gems in that wagon. We want a wagon or a barrel full of gems, full of wisdom, full of wonderful life lessons, full of knowledge. So if you continue to take these experiences and put them in your wagon, and you don't dust off the crap and get to the gym, it's going to be really hard as you get older to pull that wagon. So in order for us to move efficiently, we got to get in the habit of taking those clunks of crap, junk, whatever you want to call it, and we got to get accustomed to dusting off that gym and putting that gym into our wagon. Because if we have a wagon full of gems, it's less weight, but it's all useful information, it's all wisdom, it's all knowledge, it's what we need. And it's easier to accelerate in life with a wagon full of gems versus a wagon full of huge clunks of junk, right? So I don't want to sound insensitive and make it seem as though there aren't situations that aren't devastating. And everybody's state of devastation is devastating to them. Meaning somebody else might have lost their job, or somebody else may have lost their child. So the person who lost their job, that may not seem as devastating as the person who lost their child, right? Somebody may have, and I was talking to somebody today, she works with a group of women who have been through the prison system and whatnot, have made some bad mistakes, and she said some of these women have been hurt so bad that they turned to drugs, and they've turned to drugs, alcohol, substance abuse, and they've put their kids in danger. They've gotten a car accident. They've been irresponsible, and their kids have suffered. Sometimes they suffer and make it out, but sometimes they suffer and they actually die, right? And these women go to jail, they pay the price, and they find God, they find some higher divinity to lean on, and they find some forgiveness. And that can be devastating, right? That scenario can be devastating. I'm pretty sure there's a bunch of different scenarios that you know of, whether it's firsthand, secondhand, whether, you know, that's devastating. But we have to find a way to make sense of it all so that we can move on. Because if you keep that, if you've done something to someone, or someone's done something to you, and you can't find the meaning within it, it can become heavy. It can make it hard for you to move forward in life. And if you don't talk about it, they say when words lose their usefulness, disease sets in. So when you can't find any use for words, that's when disease sets in. That's when anxiety sets in. And anxiety can cause ulcers. It can cause many other complications. So disease can not only be actual disease, right? Meaning your body is turned on you and is causing health complications. But disease can also be doubt. It can be insecurity. It can be a negative mindset. It can be spite. It can be jealousy. It can be revenge, right? It could be attitudes that aren't redemptive. So disease doesn't have to be something that the doctor can diagnose. It could be something that the psychiatrist can diagnose. So how do we use our A game to help us make sense of what's going on? And again, I'm not saying this is easy, but I'm saying this is the process. The first thing we have to do is we have to acknowledge what has happened. There's a lot of times in which things happen to us and we won't even acknowledge it. We act like it never existed. You know what I'm saying? And it could be something as simple as, you know, your kid has issues. You're in a relationship that isn't healthy. And sometimes we like to take all of our attention and focus it on in this other area and not acknowledge the fact that our relationships aren't healthy. All right? Or we won't acknowledge the fact that maybe we didn't show up as well as we should have. And that right there, just simply acknowledging it starts the process. It helps you. You do more good. You can do more good for yourself and others by acknowledging the situation and confronting the brutal facts than you can acting like what's in front of you ain't really there, right? The next thing you have to do is accept it. So you have to accept it and say, you know, listen, I this is real. You know, this is real. This is what I did. I forgive myself. I forgive you. I failed. I didn't come through. I was irresponsible. You know what I'm saying? And not place the blame elsewhere. That's what we do a lot of times. We'll say, you know what, this happened, but I it's not my fault. It's my parents' fault. But at the end of the day, yes, our parents have something to do with how we show up in life. You know, our circumstances have something to do with how we show up in life. But you can't blame everything on your circumstances and your condition and the people around you and your parents. At some point, you have to accept responsibility for some of what took place. I'm not saying it's got to be all of it, okay? Sometimes that is the case. Sometimes you do have to take on all the responsibility. But there are times when you get a chance to say, you know what? This ain't all my fault, but I do accept responsibility for what took place in my life. Or I can accept that, you know, these things have taken place in my life, right? So there's acceptance and there's acknowledging the situation, then accepting it, right? And we accept it temporarily because I don't want you to accept verbal abuse. I don't want you to accept physical abuse for the long haul. But you do have to accept it for a little bit to appreciate it. And I know you're saying, Mar, how am I supposed to accept domestic violence? How am I supposed to accept my child being bullied? How am I supposed to accept being laid off? How am I supposed to accept losing my house? You have to accept it on some level so that you can appreciate it. And now you're asking the question, Marv, how am I supposed to appreciate these things? Sometimes, man, sometimes the universe needs to get our attention. Sometimes people come into our lives and maybe we don't recognize, we don't see them as angels, but maybe they're really angels. Maybe they're angels that have to come into our lives to provide some sort of presence, to provide some sort of lesson, and then they have to be taken away because their job was done. My grandmother, she passed out. She was in a coma for several years, and the reason in which she passed out is still unknown to this day. But I recognize that she gave everybody spiritual support. And when she went down, all those people who leaned on her for spiritual support, they've developed their own spiritual strength. And they began to help other people. So where it was one woman maybe helping out 10, those 10 people developed their strength. And then they were able to help out their own set of 10 people. You see what I'm saying? So you have one person who's helping out 10 people. That one person goes down, but those 10 people strengthen. Now all 10 of those people are helping out 10 other people. So you can see that sometimes one death can cause other people to grow. And once other people grow, now they are now strengthened and developed and strong enough to now support other people. So I'm saying that there's sometimes, man, when things happen and we have to appreciate the experience, we have to appreciate the ways in which we're going to grow because of what we went through. And then the last thing is once we have acknowledged the situation and have accepted the situation and we've appreciated it, we figured out this is why I went through what I went through. I had to go through this when I was younger. I had to go through this when I was in my middle age. I had to go through this when I was older so I can be a blessing to somebody else, so I can help somebody else. You have people who are sickly in the hospital, and they sometimes use those people as peer coaches. You know, somebody that's dealing with cancer at the age of 15 might now maybe go talk to someone else who's dealing with cancer at the same age and help them and coach them up and turn this sickness into a blessing and say, listen, I'm sick and I'm powering through. You're sick, you're discouraged, but I'm sick. I'm going to help you enhance your faith in the midst of this unfortunate time. So that's how we can sometimes take our disadvantages. We can take the things that have hurt us and we can turn those into opportunities to help someone else. And I'm not saying it's easy. I'm not saying that sometimes situations are so devastating and so hurtful that it's hard to find the acceptance. It's hard to find the strength to accept. It's hard to find the ability to appreciate, but it's the only way we can move on in life. Because if we keep on holding on to the divorce, if we don't take the divorce and shave off all the crap and find the gem, find the wisdom, then we'll be stuck. We'll be stationary. Or maybe when we should be moving, you know, efficiently through our life, we'll be barely moving in life. And where you were at. When the thing happened, you'll be there for the rest of your life. When life is going on, you having kids, you having family, you developing your family. So it's necessary that we continue to acknowledge what's going on in our lives, accept it, appreciate it, so that we can accelerate with which we need and leave behind the crap. So listen, I know that was a tough one, but it's necessary in order for us to take our situations, find meaning with them, and then and help and use those moments to help other people. So meditate on that. My name is Marv Fox, and we're done.